Welcome back, everybody, to IESF 2014 here in beautiful Baku. We have the final match of the day. It is going to be a best of three to decide who's taking third place. It is the last match for both of these teams to get in the money. So we have both of, well, not the captains. We do have Tricky, who's the captain, of course, of Team Georgia. We do have Hopis, who is part of Team Finland, because Trixie is busy preparing for this matchup by playing Hearthstone. So, Hopis, I'm going to start with you, man. Did you actually watch the match between Team Georgia and Team Romania?
Yeah, I did.
And what did you think about the matchup, both the strengths and weaknesses of Team Georgia?
Well, it went pretty much as expected. We actually saw the picks that we were expecting from both teams.
All right, so it sounds like you have Team Georgia kind of locked on. Now, Tricky, hearing that, maybe sounds like you're a little bit predictable. Do you disagree with that? Or are you maybe going to shake things up for this third place to see if you can get that money?
I'm going to try to surprise them.
All right, sounds good, man. Well, this is the last match of the day. It's going to be a best of three between Team Georgia and Team Finland. We're going to hand it off now to our commentating team. It is going to be Toby Wan and Durka casting this.
Thank you very much, Cap, and I'm looking forward to being surprised by not seeing a Medusa being picked up inside this game. I'm Toby Wan, joined by Durka.
We've only seen Medusa once this tournament, haven't we?
I know.
And that was one time too many for you.
My hate is irrational. What can I say? It doesn't need logic. It doesn't need logic at all. But I am hoping that we're going to have ourselves a good game. As I said at the end of our semi-final with Georgia, I'm looking forward to seeing the fight they took without the exorcism, that level of play in this game up against Finland. Obviously, though, the draft is going to be a very, very big thing. Finland will feel very comfortable in this. They'll feel like they're in the advantage seat again after they already had possibly the hardest matchup you could have asked for in the semifinals.
Yeah.
So they'll be coming in going, okay, maybe it's not as much pressure as it was as the first game in the morning, but still, they want to get into the prize money, which means they have to be winning this game.
Yeah, I definitely agree. The drafting is going to be a major part of this, but both teams seem to play quite aggressively. Like the Finstack, I keep calling them Finstack, Team Finland, they love to play these aggressive blink-based heroes. They get, two or three heroes that buy blink within the first 20 minutes of the game, and they just start jumping people, finding pickoffs here and there, then move that into tower advantage and take map control and completely snowball.
Mm-hmm.
Team Georgia, we saw them attempt to do that up against Romania, but they never got that ball rolling.
No, they didn't. The problem was you can't start a ball rolling when you're basically trying to push it uphill. Mm. That was their problem. They lost so many out of towers so early on. Any kind of strat which you do develop at that point is never able to be implemented because you never hit that point. That's what I like so much about the old-fashioned push strats, because you're like, oh, I'm gonna go for the mid-game, and then you're like, oh, crap, I've just lost all my Tier 1 and my Tier 2 tower 14 minutes in, and my Tier 3 tower is half dead. Like, that's what the old push strats used to be and used to punish people who were greedy in their drafts. As far as this game goes, I'm actually thinking that's one of the very smart things. Georgia, they ban out the Centaur. It had to be done. It really had to be done.
Yeah, Trixie plays that hero so well, right up to the edge of him almost dying, but he always manages to find a little nook or cranny to escape, yeah, using Stampede perfectly.
And early on, it's just, he plays it so well, hits R. Next level.
Amazing play.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Brewmaster can be banned out as well, so the poor ex-panda is incapable of being picked up. Death Prophet will be in the ban pool this time around from Jirax, even though Death Prophet was ignored till very, very late in the previous drafts.
It was like Georgia's fourth pick or something like that?
No, it was pretty late. Was it fourth or was it actually? I think it might even be fifth pick. It feels like an eternity ago. We were sitting down watching Hearthstone.
Yeah.
Because
Warrior versus Warrior.
Oh, I lost it. I lost it. Is it going to come back?
He'll come
back.
It slides across.
We're getting out of the draft?
Yeah.
There you go, right there. It was our sign to make the Hearthstone guys feel a little bit more motivated.
Especially in a Warrior versus Warrior matchup.
Yeah.
Those things can be not fun sometimes.
That's really freaking bad. It's like watching Metapod versus Metapod. who really wants to watch in that?
Metapod used Harden.
Yeah. Yeah, it's wonderful. Meanwhile, pack it out draft. So we'll have Centaur Brewmaster, Ogre Mishai will be the second ban out from Team Finland. And a hero which we have not really seen a lot of, either due to bans or due to not really just fitting the lanes properly. But it's a very early Razor pickup coming up here from Georgia. And the answer back from Finland is a very stock standard. It's a Skywrath and it's a Viper. Surprisingly, too, the Viper will be picked up against the Razor, as Razor, I don't think it's got that much of a problem playing up against the Viper.
Yeah, which makes me wonder where Finland put this. They could run it in, you know, the one position, try and farm it up, maybe with a Skywrath as support, and then have another couple of supports. But their four and five players do like to move together. They always look to smoke and find the openings on other lanes. They don't really sit back and split, have one stacking and farming the jungle, mm-hmm. then have the other one zoning someone out. They really do like to move under smoke. Skywrath, we haven't seen him too much today either. He's been banned out in the first two a couple of times.
Yeah. No, he's just sometimes way too good when you have any kind of control hero. Like, someone's going to lock you in. Hello. That's a friendly face, which doesn't actually have a face that we have not seen played on the main stage this entire tournament. Surprisingly, though, they pick it up in the second phase, in the second pickup here, and not just picking up in the second phase, because no one was going to ban the Wisp. No one was going to ban the Wisp up against them.
The trouble is, though, if you pick your Wisp combination hero now, whether that be something like Necro or Tiny, it's in Finland's mind. They think, okay, well, Wisp is a natural hero to go up with these. We've seen it before a million times. Whereas if you pick Wisp now, there are a multitude of heroes you can follow up with, and you can't really leave your Wisp combination hero for your last pick because you want to leave your mid hero there.
I wouldn't even want to pick up a full combination hero with the Wisp.
No.
Like, a Legion Commander would have fit perfectly. It's just a buff-up kind of hero. And the main reason why I'm saying that is because normally, like, I would have liked to wait until the second phase for picking for Georgia. Because now you see the Wisp, you could lose the Wisp straight away, or you can get a hero pickup. Like, you ban out Wraith, you ban out Witch Doctor. Witch Doctor, I can understand it, because the Paralyzing Cask really screws around with the Wisp because of his tether target. They're just so close that you can't separate yourself in time. But you can get something more along the lines of Burst Damage or Sendback. Sendback being the Disruptor, which would be a nice selection. Not even the greatest selection to go with the Skywrath Mage. It's lame presence, but you're missing a lot of stuns.
Go with the Tide?
You could go with the Tide Hunter as well. I have no problem with that one. The other option is, I was actually thinking, was a Lion. And you get a lot of burst damage out. And at that point, too, you've got a lot of nice control hexes, things along this line.
Yeah.
So if Razor, like, yeah.
Wisp always does suffer that problem that he's sitting at half HP for the majority of the team fight. Lion comes along with Finger of Death. And he's gone. No chance to save people with Relocate. Tether them up with Overcharge.
It's just that burst damage I'm searching for. Because you've also got Skywrath Mage. Like, you'd love to just use that seal. Like, just amplify everything up. Oh, there's a lot going on at the back end of the hall.
The HyperX girls.
Yeah. But no, seems like they're all there for the guy, man. They're all there for the guy. And half of them appear to be staff members. So Finland, their third choice right now. How do they want to try and play this? You can't predict any of the lanes. You don't know about many of the support heroes. You just try and pick your offlaner and get another piece of the puzzle from Georgia with their third pickup. Is that the better way to go right now?
Yeah, I think going the way Newbie went and just play safe and solid, picking heroes like Viper, Tide, Tank up. They've got multiple ways to go, but they go, like you said, with the Disruptor. Very good against the Wisp with that Glimpse.
I think Finland at this point would just be like, okay, well, lane control early on is kind of all we really need. If they do go for a Tiny Wisp combo, we just send the Tiny back and he becomes a non-factor. Because he's not going to be able to get back into the fight if you're relocating in like that. And the Razor, you just have like a straight lane matchup. So the only things then they require is an offlaner, which even then, when you think about it, you could run aggressively. And I'm only saying this, unless it's a dual lane in the mid. That would shut this down pretty heavily, because you're running like a non-stun lineup on the offlane. But if you have someone that's capable of doing some nice like burst damage on the offlane, just one of your heroes on the off, and you have a Skywrath Mage who's orbing as well as the storm coming out from Disruptor, not the Static Storm, just
Thunderstrike.
The Thunderstrike.
I think.
Well, you can hover over it. If I do it, I screw it up.
Thunderstrike.
There we go. We remember names. Sorry, if you use your Q ability, you can then follow up with your W.
Viper,
and then you can capitalize it with having an E.
Strangely enough, Viper is the hardest for me, because I always think Poison Attack, and then my brain tells me, no, that's too simplified. No way they're going to call something Poison Attack coming from Viper.
Then worst thing for me was actually OD.
Arcane Orb?
Mainly because I also call him OD. Because it's like, is it Outworld Devourer? Is it Outworld Destroyer? Is it whatever the hell it's going to be? But it's also because there's multiple eclipses.
Oh, lunar eclipse.
Is it you got lunar eclipse or you got Saturday eclipse?
It's just eclipse now, isn't it, for lunar?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it used to be lunar eclipse, but that was too Warcraft for us. Georgia, why do I feel we're going back into the same area we were before? There's my burst damage I was searching for, which you can get from the Timbersaw. He's also fantastic in a combination with a Disruptor and a Sky Wrath Mage. You're holding people in there, you're chain damage, you're whirling death, everyone's locked and they have no choice but to stick around. But you're picking up an SD. Now, Georgia did this last time and they picked up an LOA. That's a Warcraft 3.
There we go.
The Abaddon was selected from them last time. And it feels too defensive, unless they're going to try and use the Romanian strat and combine this up with, would you believe, the Jakiro. And then they can use the Jakiro as a core. This still puts you into that position where, what, you're running an offlane Jakiro, you're running a safe lane Shadow Demon, and then a Wiz plus one in the mid, with potentially Razor on the safe lane or Razor in the mid with the Wisp.
It feels more like the Razor plus Shadow Demon, and you've got the Static Link Disruption. It seems a little bit odd, but what other way do they run it? I think I agree with you. The Wisp goes mid with someone, Jakiro offlane, unless they change it up completely and have Shadow Demon, Jakiro, Rope. No, they can't.
They can't. You can't do that.
Unless they do something completely crazy and put Wisp solo mid, which I just don't see happening at all.
They're not Dendi.
Exactly.
He's the only one. He's the only player which has ever expressed the desire to do such a move. And very few other players actually believe him. For me right now, I'd just be more concerned that we're back into that position where you're not going to win in late game again. Your damage output is heavily reliant on the Razor getting a long-duration static link. Now, this might happen with the SD disruption, but it won't. No, actually, even then, that probably won't happen because Razor's position could be modified by the Disruptor. And if he sticks around for too long, he's going to get Viper ulted and will never be able to walk away. And when you get Viper ulted and Poison attacked, then Skywrath Mage can just drop the Mystic Flare. And if you're being aggressive with the Shadow Demon to start with, to get that Static Link off, there's no saving grace for the Razor with the Shadow Demon Disruption.
It feels like you need another ranged hero. Like, you've got four already, but going for a melee carry here.
We just go Drow. That's it. We just run Wistro middle lane. We put a Razor up on the top. Razor in the safe lane. A Drow Ranger on the safe with the SD supporting. Jakiro off lane. There you go. There's your damage you're searching for. And everything's hunky-dory. Until you get a Timbersaw chain directly into you and Disruptor's able to control you with a glimpse. Details. Small details.
So I don't really see a bad pick here for Team Finland. They could pick a multitude of heroes. Like they could just go AM and be completely safe, but that's not what they like to do. They've got Timbersaw, who I'm interested to see what build he goes for. Because we know they like building blinks, but with a Disruptor being able to glimpse people back, I don't think you necessarily need it. But you could go for blink Timbersaw, jump in.
I would still go for the blink, primarily because you want to catch the SD and the Wisp off guard. And if you're able to get in there and you're able to get your Whirling Death off straight away, then you don't care about anything else. Like, you do the initial damage, and by the time you come back out of Disruption, then you just chain and Chakram and then Whirling Death again.
And then you've got Disruptor who can, you know, put down his Kinetic Field, Static Storm, while they're busy dealing with the Timbersaw.
Exactly.
Slark, I think, is a great pick. Another Blink hero, but that's the carry they were looking for.
It's another hero, too, which can't be controlled. What are you going to do, purge him? You're in a position right now where you don't have enough control. You almost need like a Bane as your last one, or someone which 100% will stop Slark in his tracks. The Avalanche Toss might have done the burst damage required to kill him off, and that's why the fifth ban from Finland is just so smart. But this is such a huge momentum lineup. At least Georgia know what the lanes are going to be. Sort of. Because even with their offlane, like, you could run a Timbersaw safe lane, Viper in the mid, and then Slark Disrupt a Skywrath Mage on the offlane. You get one tether, that hero's gone. Pounce. If you're able to do that, then that Slark is just going to destroy, and you get a Morphling. It's an escape hero and a hero which you'll have to function with the Wisp in the mid lane.
Do you put Morph Wisp mid?
I would think you should put Morph and Wisp
so
in mid.
So then you do have the SD Razor top lane Jakiro off?
Yeah. I think it's the only thing they really can do. Unless you're going to try and run aggro on this and leave the Jakiro on the top lane. But if you do that, then you're going to lose your lane straight away. I just don't know how they're going to get there in like reach their items in time. That's the primary problem I'm looking at right now. Morphling and Razor will take some time before they really become effective. Sure, Plasma Field and Static Leak might be able to do some of the work for you, but the second Slark is able to have space in their bottom lane to get easy levels, as well as possibly picking up that early Blink Dagger, then your support's going to be in more trouble, and the supports are going to tail off for their effectiveness as well.
Fabulous.
Look at the style. Suave. Edumacated. That's a Dota player right there. She kind of actually sells Dota swag. All right, into the game we go. So, we'll have Team Finland on the Radiant side for this first best of three. It is the third place matchup. There's no lower bracket finals or anything like that. It's a single elimination tournament and our second last series to be played here on the stage for Dota 2 and our last game of the day as well. Before everyone goes home, rest, and come back at midday for our next match. So, how are we looking as far as our lanes go? Any items actually revealing this right now? Is it just going to be like a safe lane Slark and they protect him? It looks to be the case. Trixie off lane Timbersaw, and then they just run the safe lane tri lane and move the Viper into the mid.
It's a little odd looking at George's items because Morphling's gone for Ring of Protection, which indicates safe lane, and Razor has gone for, Boots First, which indicates mid lane. So it looks like they will be putting Razor mid and they have the defensive tri lane top.
Well, this allows Morphling. I don't see a problem, though, for the Morphling. I don't see a reason why you have to get the Ring of Protection this early on. Like, he's not going to be worried about Timbersaw dishing out damage to him. So
especially not physical damage.
No. So it's a bit of a waste when you think about it, because you could have just picked up something like a Circlet with that kind of money, which has got an extra 25 gold just sitting there. And then that'll go in to your Wraithband Ring of Aquila, which is what the Morphling, I believe, is trying to build with that.
Well, he wants the Basilius early enough so he can use multiple waveforms over the next 3 or 4 minutes, because obviously you get the flat mana regen with the Basilius and not the percentage based, but I don't know.
Using multiple waveforms, it would only be for farming then. It's the Timbersaw, maybe, yeah, you waveform out, but your Wisp and your Shadow Demon aren't enough control to bring down a Timbersaw. And they don't have enough burst damage in them either, with the Stout Shield up, and he probably will just get a point of reactive army. He'll wait until he needs it. But just getting a single point up in reactive armor will be enough regeneration, because they don't burst damage down a Timbersaw, which is normally what you search for. Like, if you're looking to kill off a Timbersaw, like if Shadow Demon starts his poison right now, he still gives him a reactive armor charge on this. So you're seeing his regeneration. 11.2 a second, and then Munchers on a Tango as well. So the poison is hurting, but that's 50 mana for every poison you're throwing out. He's just blown half of his mana to take away one Tango charge. And a grand total of 40 life points.
Yep.
So, that's, yeah. This is when you try and find efficiency inside of your items. The one thing the Wisp has done nicely, though, is the ability to do this.
Double stack.
Yeah. But who have you got that's going to be flash farming this? Is it Morphling? Or is it meant to be Plasma Field Razor?
Well, what item do you want from Razor that quickly? Because Razor can get mech mid fairly quickly up against the...
Oh, he has to go mech mid too, because there's no one else going to buy that. Jakiro needs to go for the Yule Scepter. If they don't even get the controlling ability from him, then they're in a lot of trouble.
Especially because the Viper hasn't gone boots first. He went for that Wraithband, and the Razor has. If the Razor can control this lane equilibrium well enough, which is going to be difficult now, he's got two range creeps pushing up the ramp. Just depends on where that next wave goes. He should be able to zone the Viper out. But the Morphling, I don't know. You've got to go Lincolns in this game because the amount of single target, the Ancient Seal is a killer.
Yeah, but if you're going a Lincoln Sphere, the Lincoln Sphere is just going to end up being regeneration as well as life points. That's all it's really going to be. And we're back to square one of where does our damage really come from? And you're going to take so long to get that Lincoln Sphere. You're still looking like 20, 23 minutes before that Lincoln Sphere is going to be ready to run. So after that point, you go to your damage dealing item, or you go for your survivability, like you go into a mana style or something like that, but you're still not finding enough damage which will deal with the Slark in time before he's just able to Shadow Dance and run away.
Same thing applies if the Morphling goes for Midas, which is another option. The Slark is just going to imitate his build.
True.
And the Slark will always be ahead just because of the skill set he has.
Yeah, because Slark can basically gank by level 2, level 3. All he's got to do is just get that leash. And on an offlane Jakiro, that's really problematic, because it's the offlane Jakiro who can just get leashed up, and then pull back out again. Like, even if he starts walking away, the Disruptor can come over and just glimpse him if he can find enough levels.
Jirax is doing a really great job here, pretty much doing the same thing the Whisper's doing on this medium and small camp.
Yeah, it's the right thing to do when you pull high, because then, like, we did see it earlier today too, like, you get the box is really thin on the top, so you can drag up and then just go from there. We do have Timbersaw back inside the game, but we've had one of our players run off to the race for people with extremely weak bladders. He's gone to the loo. That's why we're missing. And also why we're not showing the game up on the live stream. I think we've been a little bit negative about the draft from the dire side. But we are just trying to understand it a little bit more.
Well, I think Razor does a good job mid, and he's going to get his mech quickly.
Mm.
But it's the actual transition, like you said, the damage. Once again, where does it come from? What is the role of the Wisp? If they can TP, if they can get the vision up in the enemy jungle and find TPs onto Disruptor and Skywrath with the relocate, then sure, they can find pickoffs and maybe turn that into towers with the Jakiro. The Timbersaw, he is going to have a pretty good time up here. But yeah. his item build really does depend on where the supports go. Because if they allow him to farm here, he's going to get Arcane Boots and possibly just go straight into Bloodstone.
That'll be all the regeneration you really search for from Trixie as well. And with this type of lineup coming out from Georgia, you could be losing that SDM Wisp in every single engagement, which means those Bloodstone charges will really start to rack up. But at the same time, I think Trixie's, one of his primary goals should definitely be getting to that Scythe of Ice at one point. Hey! You spin me right round. But just being able to get to that Scythe of Ice, because then it's just the control over the Razor and the Morphling. If you can bring one of these guys down, you're basically good to win the fight from there. But looks like we have Wisp back, so he'll sit himself down. And looks like Michel David Johns says we're ready to go. And the headset's on, so we're good to start again. And so, double stacks. One of them was able to work, the other one was not. Oh, that's a nice wall. Actually trapping in the Jakiro on the bottom lane. And this is that leash timer we're talking about. Very rarely do you see a disrupt the level up kinetic field like that. But he saw the opportunity and went for it. Hmm. While in middle lane, the Razor. I'm interested to see just how well he's going to deal with this mid lane now. With Skywrath Mage being a little bit more active against the Razor, they're trying to bring him down. The Wisp, okay, now he's fine. With Wisp bottle charges, any kind of damage they deal out to the Razor, the Wisp just will inflict onto himself and... Well, actually, he needs to inflict it somewhere else and then just bottles him up. Right. So, Slark, do you really want to see the Midas on him?
It depends on what the Morphling does. If the Morphling goes Midas, he should as well. If the Morphling decides to go straight into Lincoln's, he should go for Treads, Ring of Aquila, Blink, and just start fighting. Because the more you fight, the longer it's going to take the Morphling to get that Lincoln's. Because you're going to be putting pressure on bot lane and mid lane, force movement from the rest of the team, but the Wisp and the Shadow Demon, they can't really defend towers on their own.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be down to the Jakiro just trying to hold this off. So once the push does come, they're going to move from lane to lane, and then Morphling's going to find himself spending so much money on TPs to TP out of danger or into a fresh lane that it's going to cripple his economy.
That's Static Link going over to the Skywrath Mage Razor. He's got one level up in Plasma Field, but now the damage actually a little bit too much. The Radiant Courier does go down. Is there a poison? It's not fast enough, not with the heal coming in from the Wisp. But then again, Wisp, Tether, he'll go back again. The orb ticked down. He just bottles him up.
Kinetic Field on bot lane.
Are they going all the way down into... Okay, is Jakiro trying to stay in the trees? But he gets locked in here. They've got to make sure they get the leech. Is there any kind of way to drag it back? Yep,
yes.
Last second glimpse. And that'll be first blood and the Jakiro on the off lane. You took about the Jakiro trying to hold him off. How do you do that when you're only halfway into level one right now?
Yeah, it's really tough. And the Team Finland proving me wrong. They've sent this Skywrath mid. I said their two supports don't really like to split up. They move together a lot the time of the smoke.
Oh, Trixie. This is that time when the disruption doesn't work for you. What that actually did was allowed Timber Chain to come back off cooldown again. So he was just able to use that to get the kill. One of those times, like, the disruption is one of these things. I know anyone who's played many pubs with a Shadow Demon, you know sometimes they're the most brilliant saving things in the world, and sometimes they hurt you so badly.
And this is the push on the bot tier 1. Like, they're not even pushing heroes, but the fact that they can send the creep wave all the way up, they're farming at the same time, killing Jakiro, making sure, you know, he's not getting farm. He's just hit level 3, which is pretty good for him, and finishes Tranquil Boots. Is that his? Yeah, he's got Ring of Regen back on the courier. But it's still a really difficult lane for him.
Mm-hmm. I'm waiting for this bottom lane to try and have another crack. With an orb of venom over on the Slark, you know he just wants to get that easy pounce and drag that Jakiro's light points down. But he needed the second level over on the Disruptor with Glimpse. But he can't get it until Disruptor hits level 4. Because Disruptor went the 1-1-1 build. That middle lane too, as I was kind of expecting, once the Viper started getting up at a little bit more levels, the Razor just doesn't really control any kind of CS here anymore. And you got Trixie, who's being so over-aggressive. He only got 1 point up in the reactive armor, but again, he knows he can get very easy kills on this top, but he's 90 gold away from having Arcane Boots, which means easy spam coming directly off that. Make it now 35 gold, make it now. So level 6 as well, so Sharkrim's available, Arcane Boots will be purchased up. And the Shadow Demon, in fact, cannot contest him anymore. Yeah. If he comes over and tries to fight, Trixie will just turn and engage.
I love the fact that he's gone for 3 levels in Dimper Chain because he knows that Disruption is the only thing that can stop him. Morphling really isn't going to go an early level in Adaptive Strike, so yep. He's got the longer range initiation or the longer range escape.
What are you going to try and do? Right, disrupt him halfway through is... Yeah.
That's the only thing you can do.
The second you do that, you can't cast it fast enough. The animation time...
He's not going to throw the Timber Chain anyway unless he knows Disruption's been used, because there's no point. He's just going to walk away.
Yeah.
So then you have to disrupt him to stop him, and then he'll use the Timber Chain.
Then again, even if you do disrupt with the 3 points up in Timber Chain, you can't walk away.
Also, unless you micro the illusions, they're just going to stack up the reactive armor for him.
That's true, because they'll just attack automatically onto the target.
Yep.
So he'll get instantly 2 extra points up in reactive armor. Razor dropping down to half of his life points. This Viper... He's about to crack level 6, and Razor, if he does that again, he'll die. It really is just that simple. So you've got also Slark on bottom lane. He's going, it looks like Treads is coming his way. He's got the boots, it could just be the Midas glove, but if he's going to go for Midas, he'd wait to buy the full recipe instead. So I'm going to say there's going to be a Treads fighting Slark very early on. They don't want to hold back, and Jirax has got a great rune. That's going to be up against the Wisp. He'll tether away. It's only a level 1 glimpse. In fact, he's holding on to that second, that fourth ability point. Deciding what he wants to do. Trixie, chains down, brings that Sharkrim back in again. Forces the waveform of the Morphling out. While on bottom lane, that's where Jirax wants to go. The Leech connects perfectly on the Jakiro, and he's just walking around in circles, but Slark will take this kill on the bot lane. Very quick, very efficient, and we're now 7 minutes in, and the Jakiro is at 4.5 levels. Compared to the other Jakiros we've been seeing earlier today from the Romanians, this Jakiro is, well, it's third world Jakiro.
I wonder if Slark thinks now that because he's so far ahead of this Morphling with a couple of kills under his belt, Morphling has not gone for the Midas, gone for the Treads. That delays his Lincolns even further. So he's not stayed on Brown Boots. He's decided, okay, I need the extra agility. I need the attack speed to try and hit this Timbersaw out of the lane, possibly. He might go Midas on the Slark.
I don't see a need for it. I really don't see a need for it. Well, I can understand the reasons why he would do it, as you were just listing most of them. It's
well, you'll get your Midas at 8.5 minutes or 8:45, and then your Blink Dagger will take another 4 minutes or so. So you'll have, let's say, a 14-minute Blink Dagger Midas at the latest. Then you'll get Treads.
There's that middle lane. I was flagging it before. Viper gets level 6. Razor can't be over-aggressive. Or Skywrath just comes in with Sealing Concussive. Now, the wall's gone down, and that's Jirax actually holding the Jakiro there. The Wisp supporting the bottom lane. That's another reason, too, why the Razor was capable of dying in the mid lane. I'm just sitting here going...
Does he need it?
Hmm? Does he need the Midas?
Does the Slark need it? Like it would improve.
I don't think he does. I really don't think he does. If he gets the Blink Dagger, they gain more momentum. They basically keep Georgia on the back foot. Mm. And the supports can't do anything. Like, you can keep the supports below level 6. The Wisp is still only 3.5. If you get a Slark with a Blink Dagger and he has level 6, he's moving, and he already has that. He's level 7. He's running so quickly across this map and pouncing everywhere that there is nowhere safe unless they group up as 2 or 3, and then you start restricting all the levels which are coming into the cores.
It is the safe option, though.
It is. Oh, really? How the hell
Double
are they this unlucky? Come on. Come on, they have to use magical damage to clean up these camps. They don't have a physical damage clearer, and they got double mud golems who are immune to that magical damage.
That's not fair, man.
It really isn't. Like, that is just, that's just Dota being cruel right there. And the sad thing is, too, well, Finstack, damn it, you've done
I'm
things
sorry.
To me, Derica.
I'm so sorry.
No, they're coming middle lane again. Viper does have the Viper strike, but you realize that's a Jakiro and a Razor in mid lane. And the ping came out saying, yo, why they got two core heroes here in the middle lane, we should be forcing out that bottom lane, and it is actually Midas.
Yeah. How do you react to this tier 1 push? Because you can't send Shadow Demon or Wisp or Jakiro down here.
You let it go. You defend tier 2 tower. You send these two heroes down, and the Slark pounces up and kills you.
And this is where the problem with the Morphling I was talking about comes. They take this tier 1, and then the Slark is free to either farm bot and get his blink, or just move around the map.
Yep.
He's going treads first, so he can actually just go and kill people.
That is the crazy thing. Like, for me, if he had a blink dagger, then the SD would be dead right now.
Yeah.
But because he's got the Midas, he gets the treads now. They just go in again. It might be the quickest. Okay, that works. The wall comes up. There goes your pounce. And Shadow Demon will die a different way. The Thunderstrike is going through him. And oh, he's actually trapped. He's locked in the middle of it. He had to fight his way out of that one. He could just Shadow Dance at any moment. So there's no chance that they'll actually kill the Slark. But as you can see right there, the initiation power of this Slark is too much for any of the supports from Georgia to handle, let alone the cores, which are now trying to farm up the jungle side. This is what a Jakiro is being pushed to. Liquid fire farming stacked camps.
Which are really meant for the Morphling to take him up to the next item. And Trixie is left on his top lane, Sol Ring Arcanes, well on his way to Bloodstone.
Skyrim Mages. Even if he farms this right now, he's going to give all the experience over. The hilarious thing is, he can get this kill.
He's going to waveform over the cliff.
With the waveform up, he's away. But if he didn't waveform right then, he decided to walk the old-fashioned way. Actually, does he even win on movement speed? 375 versus...
No.
335.
Skywrath is crazy fast.
Yeah, which means Skywrath Mage would actually catch up to the Morphling, would have sealed him up if he didn't waveform up. There goes your T1 tower while in the middle lane. They seal up on the Razor. He took the Plasma Field off, so the damage was there. And then Trixie, easy move into. It's a one-for-one trade-off because Skywrath Mage went down. Nice Ice Path. Liquid Fire is not actually helping their case because it's not triggering out that reactive armor of Trixie, who now gets away. Waveform up. The Viper, no ultimate available. He is still regenerating up, just got most of the mech. In fact, he can actually buy the full mech right now, which he will do so. So it's a 1-1 trade-off. You lost your Skywrath for the Razor. And you stopped the Razor from... Like, if Razor had a little bit more time and didn't die, then he'll be a lot closer towards those drums he's trying to buy. So this is still better for Team Finland. Because they also got a tower to boot. And you can see a 5,000 net worth up, just over 4,000 in the experience.
And Slark has plenty of stacks to take in the jungle. Only level, one level in Dark Pact, but it doesn't really matter too much with the stout shield. You should be able to farm these up nicely.
And they can now try and farm up top lane heroes. Razor, ultimate, it's the Static Storm. They don't have to glimpse him back. In fact, they just hold him here with the Sharkrams, and they slice through him. 6-1, and the Razor, second death on the board. He is moving further away from finishing up those drums. And they probably may even, I don't know if they'll lose their T1 tower on top lane. If they come to defend it, they'll probably lose the hero that comes to defend it.
But see, Slark can sit here, bot. The Morphling can't come down here. Mid lane, Razor really needs to go here and farm.
They found the Morphling. He's sealed up. He's luckily sitting there with 1,000 life points. The timing of it! It was off, he waveformed just a fraction of a second too early, which means the glimpse did actually drag him back. Trixie will kill him off. Things just not going right for Georgia.
Everything that's going wrong is going wrong.
You knew you're gonna die anyway.
Yeah.
Like, at that point, he potentially could have lived because he was able to be at 1,000 life points when they initiated, which means the strength morph was gonna bring him back up again, and he should have been able to get away. Trixie was dropping a little bit lower on mana, so he may not be able to keep Timber Chaining to chase him all the way. So he had the chance to get away, but when you have the glimpse like that, you know the seal's already going to be there. If they actually had the mana for Mystic Flare, he would have been dead a lot faster.
13-minute Bloodstone on Trixie.
At the what? Already?
He's got the recipe on the courier.
Oh, man. With an Observer behind the Tier 1 tower in the top lane too, they know how much they're up against. And this is the crazy thing too. It's like Slark is free to move anywhere he wants to. He's got 1,800 gold 13 minutes in as well. So with this, they can just start ganking, and those Bloodstone charges are going to really start to like add up. Shadow Demon, hello. Drops the Observer Ward, Jakiro. All right. Troublesome. Oh, they relocated in. He saw him, and there's that glimpse. This just completely disables the combo. It isolates the Wisp. He has then TP'd the Morphling in, but the Morphling's missed his timing window. They do have a lot of damage coming to the Skywrath Mage, but then Slark joins the battle. The Dark Pack damage. The Storm was already out. Three for the price of one, and they're going to go further. The slower Morphling waveform in 2 seconds' time. Slark wanting to pounce up, and he actually... Ooh, he's almost able to control the Wisp. The Dark Pack damage. 3 seconds until the next pounce, and there won't be a tether option. Sharkram, he doesn't really dodge it properly, and the Slark will just pounce in to get the final hit in. There will be an Ice Path, which means a dual Breath of Harassment into the Slark, but this achieves nothing. He goes out of vision and will heal back up again, and he has 2.5k gold now.
Yeah, he's got enough of Blink Dagger and more. Might even be worth going Shadow Blade in this game. I'm not sure you need Blink.
Hilarious thing is, you actually look at the experience change. There's only 1,700 difference in the XP change with the gold, and it was a 4-for-1 trade-off. That's how much the heroes are worth right now on Team Finland.
Bloodstone starts with 8 charges, yeah?
Yes, Bloodstone starts with 8 charges.
Trixie buys it, and then a minute later he's got 12 charges on it.
His death timer is actually... Does it even hit 0 because it's so early in the game?
It'd be very short. It goes down to 1.
Trixie's now building into the Aghanim Scepter as well. So not only does he have a Bloodstone, he's got a casual point booster to build into it. So Aghanim's now we can start counting it. First Sharkram, Timber Chain up. He wasn't able to get the pull through with the Sharkram as well. And Razor is just quite happy to Static Link, but he only steals 14 damage.
Morphling says hello to bottom lane, but Slark is there to greet him, blinks on him straight away, and has already sent Morphling to hell between his legs back to the fountain.
Can no other choice? Huh. The T1 tower, this is now the other point. Your counter push is dual breath, plaster field, waveform. Waveform puts you out of position, so you don't want to use that. And plaster field probably means you're a little bit too close that you can get pounced on by the Slark. So problems are coming from all angles right now that there's just no way to defend it. They can't come out and attack because it's going to be an SD disruption, which is the aggressor. But they SD disrupt, and that then buys time for Team Finland to move over.
Trixie? Right. Hello?
I don't think he really cares right now, man. He chains away, avoids the ice path, because he's got the rest of his team coming up apart from the Slark. They're all up here on the top lane ready to fight. And now, well, Skywrath Mage, he's the one that's in a little bit more trouble. The Static Storm comes out from Jirax. In fact, Morphling waves in. He is the one to get the first kill here, but there's more trouble on the back line. There's 2-for-1, the Glimpse trying to make sure they all have to stick around. You've got Jakiro being leashed up right now by Slark. He's dominating everything and will move over towards the Morphling. Waveform up, he's stuck on top of the cliff. That relocate goes a grand total of 1 micron. And then Morphling still stuck up on top of the hill. There's a replicate which he can jump down to. He's trying to get it further away. That's why the Ping Yao is saying, please kill off the replicate. Is there a pounce? He could just go into the Shadow Dance. That glimpse, it puts him back on the hill. He's got no mana to get down. He's actually going to die on top of the cliff because... Oh, no, he's going to Intel Treads. He Intel Treads and gets back down again. I had to take it all back right now. Morphling will survive. Then it's 15-3 and it's 14 Bloodstone charges on a Timbersaw.
Where was his Replicate Illusion? Where was his Replicate Illusion?
It got left behind. It stayed right here.
Okay.
So he decided to go out that direction, and then the Replicate was... it was down on low life anyway. He got the right target, though. We got the Timbersaw. Yeah. But you couldn't do anything with it. George? And because he couldn't move it fast enough, he couldn't reposition with it.
Georgia did a decent job of splitting the fight there, and they sent Timbersaw this way, forced to chase the Razor, then relocated here to try and find pickoffs. But the Viper and Slark coming in for the battle.
Oh, glimpse! Dragging him back. He disrupted, but it was at the last moment. He still gets pulled back. And poor Shadow Demon. He is literally spilling his blood into that Timbersaw.
Morphling has a good couple of seconds to farm this bot lane, but I don't know how long. Someone's going to TP down here and say goodbye.
I love how positive you are, Durka. I really love how positive you are.
He gets a grand total of, 15 seconds, and then someone TPs down and... shoes him off the lane.
Who knows? Maybe he can pick up that ultimate orb, have some extra stats during the fight.
I'm sorry, sir. You are not
meant
to be here.
And then that actually is turned against you by the Timbersaw.
Please stay off the grass, Morphling.
At least he gets a level one a tier one tower fortification out. But that's an 18-minute Aghanim Scepter with the Mecha from the Viper. Trixie, what do we actually got in the courier? It's a BT recipe coming in for Trixie. Potentially, if he didn't buy up those BTs, he would now be very, very close to his Aghanim Scepter. Is that an attempted relocate save? Glimpses? You can't run away. This is from the pickup on the third selection was so big, and this, I think, still goes back to draft.
Yeah.
You pick the Wisp up so early, you know what you're going up against, so you draft accordingly. You have to try and keep these strats secret, or else they can be completely counterpicked. Which kind of feels like what this game is.
I also think the Necro ban from Team Finland was very strong. That was most likely what Georgia was going for, to try and sustain through the team fights, have Mech on the Razor and just keep on going and pushing with the Jakiro.
Trixie. They've actually got SD going over on the Slark. Trixie takes so many of the life points away from the Jakiro. He's got Timbertain in 1 second time. He's close enough for it while the Slark does pick off the Shadow Demon. 20-3 now on the border. The Razor is getting closer towards his BKB, but he's also about to die because Trixie TP's up. The support's coming in from the Slark, who runs so quickly through the trees. And do they actually have enough damage with the pouncing with the Dark Pack? No, they do not. And there's no hero to glimpse him away. But the tier two tower's lost on bottom.
18 Bloodstone charges. He has enough for Blink, but no, he's going to finish the Axe first.
Yeah, it's Axe. Axe. He doesn't have to go Blink in this game. It's not required of him. And now TP's on bottom lane, finishing the tower will be the Viper. Will then TP out the Ice Path. Actually, they pushed him in with the Adaptive Strike. He wasn't in range of the Ice Path then. But Ogre makes sure it will actually happen. But Trixie's forcing out the top lane. So tier 2 tower for the Viper on the bottom. That actually works out nicely as far as experiencing gold. Coming the way here. There's actually 2,000 experience without one kill. Being split four ways, of course.
Still a lot.
Chirax. Slark's coming in. He's going to try and fight this. They're actually going to see who's going to come down and battle up against Trixie. Wisp checking out the tree line over on the side. Trixie moves up. He's looking through those trees. Just, in fact, not a fan of Greenpeace. But he wants to catch up to the Shadow Demon, and that's a long way back. Into the Shadow Demon. He'll get sliced in two. And Razor found the Radiant stack. Would you believe it? He could actually move over that Mithril Hammer soon.
BKB's pretty important for him up against Trixie mainly, who's been jumping on him and just slicing him to bits.
That's a 21-minute axe. Yeah. With 19 Bloodstone charges.
Well, you look at his net worth, 12,500 gold.
Yeah, it's not too shabby, man.
It's 2.5 times the Morphling's.
he's just shy of 600 gold in experience a minute. Bottom lane, Jakiro's dead. Blink in, leash. And Jakiro, he can Ice Path, but he can't break himself free of the leash. And Slark will commit for this one. He needs one more attack, or maybe he won't. In fact, there's a copy of Slark. And Jakiro should count himself very, very lucky he survives this. They use one of the very sparing Urn Charges. Shadow Demon! He wasn't ready for the double Chakram. He really, really wasn't. If it wasn't for his stick charges right now, he'd be dead. But Finland just moved into the tier 2 tower in the mid lane. Trixie keeps the pressure on the bottom lane. He knows he can basically 1v4 at the moment.
Creep waves just cease to exist when Trixie's on this lane.
Mm-hmm.
With this Catapult here, I'm surprised he's not sticking around.
What do we go next over on the Timbersaw?
Shivas, Hex.
All of the above.
It doesn't really matter. Like, there's no bad item, I don't think.
Yeah, there really isn't. He spent something. And we've got... what have we got? Actually, no, that's Jirax's Ogre Club and Orb of Venom. No, he didn't. So yeah, 1,200 gold still over on the Timbersaw. Well, he's definitely trying to keep these reactive armor charges up by staying in close. Okay. This is one of those moments now where this is the last play. This really is the last play.
The Hail Mary pass.
If they're going to do this, they got to smoke, they got to move out. And in fact, they put the sentry ward down just so they can do such a thing. They can walk past the observer wards and you try and go for the steal. You have to be quick because you know, in fact, Team Finland are not that quick, but you can't smoke down when you have a Timbersaw smack bang on the bottom lane, which means there's no surprising. In fact, Slark just blinks up. There's your tether up. It's like they're trying to force him to fight by going for Roshan without seriously doing it. The Macropie Ice Path, well off target, actually affecting none of the heroes. They slice the Jakiro out. And this will now be also the Razor to get caught out in the mid lane. Slark will move up. He's looking for the pound's target. He'll have more support coming in from G-Rex to try to hold him out with a wall. And now he can just glimpse him back. Needs the vision, and he's got it. Pulls him all the way back. Double Chakrams. And that's 3 heroes down for Georgia. And this should, in fact, be mid-Rax as well.
I wonder if their plan was to try and kill Trixie there, because the Shadow Demon moved forward and then realized, hang on, the Chakira should be first. But then the smoke popped. The Chakira ran, trying to get the Yules off onto Trixie. Wisp.
GG! 23 minutes in, the Wisp had to really get himself back in again, but this game is more than over. It was a rough time. That was a very, very rough time right there. It was momentum-based heroes, both a Slark and a Timbersaw being picked up. When you have that kind of stuff, and they even get like a basic good start, you're in trouble. But there was no way to control the Timbersaw. The Timbersaw on the offlane was perfect. The Slark pickup destroyed, like, almost completely the Jakiro offlane. When you're sitting 7 minutes in, you're still desperately trying to get to a level 3 Liquidfire, you've got nothing. And the power of having that Jakiro on the offlane is fighting those early levels as a solo, and surviving, and then pushing in the towers.
Yeah, and then that Skyrath, who went mid to weather the storm for that Viper yep. against the Razor. The first 3 levels are vital, and the fact that he managed to get boots plus more regen and get up to treads and actually win that lane, mm-hmm. then the Wisp, who went bottle as his first item, it's like he saved up his first gold for that bottle,
yeah.
but the Skyrath was always on top rune, just ready and waiting to take it, so there's no chance for the Wisp.
Yeah, and really, Wisp, too early pickup. If you're going to grab him, it's got to be in the second phase. We said during the game, and we'll probably wrap up this game number one with that phrase, it was too easy to see what was going to happen, and the counterpicks just came very, very thick and fast. So game number two of our third place matchup will be coming up shortly. Finland going up against Georgia. Will be Finland going 2-0? We'll find out. See you soon.